Hi. Welcome to JC Chapel. Hope this chapel makes you peaceful and comfortable in the name of Christ. Today, we're going to learn continually about superheroes of the Bible. As of episode 2. Last JC Chapel, I talked about justice and story of King David. In the battle between the Israelites and the Philistines, there was one giant called Goliath. The Israelites soldiers were terrified by Goliath's physical power and incredible fighting skills. Goliath talked about God. The Israelites believed and cursed him with ridiculous teasing. However, there was no one who wants to fight with Goliath among the Israelites. In this moment, David, a little boy from the farm as a shepherd, came up and voluntarily want to fight with Goliath. What an amazing heart confession. Make a short, David killed Goliath with sling and stones, as you know that. David killed Goliath because of, it is called, holy discontent, which fights for evil spirits. With holy discontent, God came to David and he gave David with God's power to fight and kill Goliath. Today, let's talk about power. We could ask that two questions. First question, what kind of power superheroes of the Bible receive from God? Number two question is, how did superheroes of the Bible use the incredible power from God in their lives? Very meaningful questions. In order to know the details, let's continually learn about the story of King David. By the way, power. When we know more about power, I suddenly think of one of the famous DC characters, Superman, all right, Superman. I love Superman. Superman. All right, let me give you some information about Superman. Superman, Clark Kent, faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive, the Man of Steel. You know that. The last son of Krypton fights a never-ending battle for truth and justice. From his blue uniform to his flying red cape to the S-shield on his chest, Superman is one of the most immediately recognizable and beloved DC superheroes of all time. The Man of Steel is the ultimate symbol of truth and justice and hope. What a great message he all the time brings. He's the world's first superhero and a guiding light to all. Superman possesses powers and abilities. There are about 6 powers and abilities. Number 1, the powers of a flight. Number 2, enhanced hearing. Number 3, superhuman strength. Number 4, X-ray vision. Number 5, hit vision. Number 6, cold breath. Let me break down. Number 1, the power of flight. Superman flies with not boing sound, but whoosh like a rocket, or whoosh like a jet. Boom, boom, boom. Whoosh, 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 like this way. Number 2, enhanced hearing. Superman has a super hearing that lets him hear things in other cities and even other planets, and hear in frequencies beyond the human range. Number 3, Superman strength.
Well, please be my guest.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you even pulling? Are you on my team?
Thor's favorite weapon, as you know that, Mjolnir. This is the only weapon Thor can lift up. Because what? His power. Thor's power. But Superman is another person lift up the Mjolnir. So it has so much strong power and strength.
Right.
Number four, Superman possess X-ray vision. Superman's eyes change the image of visible being in the mechanical monsters. X-ray vision is a term that describes the ability to see through solid objects. Wow, cool. Number five, heat vision. Heat vision is a superpower possessed by Kryptonians when exposed to yellow sun C photonucleic effect. It is the ability to release massive amounts of solar energy stored within the body through the eyes, the focused beams of heat. Number six, cold freezing breath, super breath. Superman's breath was capable of freezing objects and generating hurricane force winds. His super breath can extinguish fires and freezing things. He could also hold his breath indefinitely, allowing him to travel underwater or in space without breathing apparatus. Wow, it's cool. I wish it like that. I'm sure Goliath is not Superman, but he was incredible, invincible, and had a mighty power in the battle. That's why the Israelites were terrified. However, David, who trusts God and believed that God, our God, is powerful and invincible. 1 Samuel chapter 17 said, let's check it out, verse 45. David replied to the Philistine, "You come to me with sword, spear, and javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of heaven's armies, the God of the armies of the Israel, whom you have defied. Today, the Lord will conquer you." And last verse, 47. "This is the Lord's battle. He will give you to us, the Israelites." David, he was small little boy, but he was brave person when he received the power of God. He was able to fight the giant who had the power, military training, Goliath. And he killed Goliath in front of all people. Why? Because King David received the power of God. Let's go back to the question we talked about before. Question number one, what kind of power King David, a superhero of the Bible, received from God? The answer is this one, verse 45. Courageousness. Verse 45 to 46 said, David replied to the Philistine, "You come to me with sword, spear, and javelin." You know what? King David said, "You brought a lot of equipment and weapons, but I don't have it. I only have just stone and sling. This is the only one I have. Why? Because I received the power of God. And let me know." Okay, verse 46 said, "Today the Lord will conquer you, you enemies, and then God will show me the power of God." Number two, question number two is this one. How did King David, a superhero of the Bible, use the incredible power from God in his life? So when he received the power, the King David, how did he use the power of God in the battle? That's the question. Let's check it out. 47, chapter 17. "This is the Lord's battle, and he will give you to us." Another word, proclamation. David made a great, faithful confession in front of the enemies in the battle. The Philistine and Goliath tease God and curse God with bad words. David trust, but prayed, and God will give him his almighty power to David. David received God's power to fight the enemy and proclamation faithfully to the world. God is control. God is in control. God conquers the world. God protects his children, his people from the enemies. David faithfully proclaimed, "Our God is with us, and God conquers the world. We belong. We live right now. King David is the person called one of the superheroes of the Bible. And many Christians and people respect him as the faithful king in God. Today, many people want some almighty powers that control others and our society or world. It is clearly to know that superheroes of the Bible receive the power of God and use it for God and His people. Let's keep in mind that God is looking for the people who want to use His powers for God and for His people. Amen? Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you for your blessing. And thank you for this great message, superhero of the Bible. We can become your superhero today until we see you. Give us your power that we just proclaim your words, your name, your love, your grace to many, many people, especially in COVID-19 situation and then pandemic season. And thank you so much for this courageous message that we come to you, receive the power, and then faithfully we proclaim your name in the world. I pray in Jesus' name, amen. Okay. Huh?